Hello! Today we will be covering how to connect from a PC with iRev to a 920i indicator. When you download iRev, you actually get two different versions of iRev installed. Both versions work with the 920i, but one version is for indicators with firmware at version 3.14 or older, while the other is for firmware version 4 or newer. So the first thing to determine is the version of your indicator. For this demonstration, I will be using firmware version 5.10, so I will need iRev for 4 or newer. Second, we need to know what method we will be using to connect. iRev provides us with several options to connect to a 920i indicator. To see the connection options, we will go to Tools, and then Options. Our options are 232.422 connection, an RS-485 connection, TCP/IP connection, or connecting with a phone modem. For this demonstration, I will be using RS-232. For the ease of connection, I will be using port 2 on the 920i, which has a 9-pin serial connector. So now that we know what port we will be using on the indicator, we need to know what port we will be using on our computer. In order to determine that, we will be opening the Windows Device Manager located in the control panel. From here, we go down until we find the option marked Ports, COM, and LPT. For connections to the indicator, the ones marked COM will be the ones that work. As you can see here, my only option is COM4, so I know what connection I will be using. In the event that you have multiple COM ports, you may need to troubleshoot to figure out which ones you will use. Now that we know our ports, we will need to determine our connection speed. iRev does have a feature for detecting the baud rate of the indicator, but since I know my port on the 920i is set to 115-200 baud, I will uncheck the auto baud feature and set the baud rate manually. To manually set the baud rate, you need to proceed to Settings under the Communications menu. Here is where I set which COM port I am using, as well as verifying the baud rate, data bits, parity, and stop bits all match what my indicator is set to. With that finished, I will now move on to the main screen and go to Communications and Connect. Here we get the connected message, but we also get another message. We get this error because our hardware does not match the indicator's hardware. Since the purpose of this video was connecting to iRev and not downloading a program, this message will not be an issue. Once you accept it, the slots in the hardware configuration area will fill up with the hardware in your indicator. If you have a custom program you are trying to download, you need to make your hardware match from indicator to iRev. Otherwise, it will wipe out all configuration in the .920 file. This has been a demonstration on how to connect to iRev. Thank you for your time.